So in the previous video, we have seen how to detect if there was some inconsistency in the all different constraints. When we come to the reasoning that we need to discover how to remove inconsistent values, it means that we should remove edges so that if you would assign this variable to this value, so to the if you would decide to put the corresponding edge inside the matching, then you would it would lead to an inconsistency. Okay, and this is what we mean by domain consistency for the all different constraints. And so what we need to remove, the goal here is to remove any edge that belong to none of the maximum matching. Or if I do the dual reasoning, I want to remove all the edges that do not belong to some maximum matching. Okay, if it belongs to at least one maximum matching, then I should not remove it. And one important observation here is that we have discovered an algorithm before, which was the augmented path algorithm to discover maximum matching. Surely doesn't mean that there are no other maximum matching with the same number of edges. So different solutions that would be equally good, that would match exactly the same number of variables, exactly the same variables. Okay. And so one possibility to detect all the edges that do not belong to any maximum matching is to enumerate them all. So, and if assume that I have an algorithm that is able to enumerate all the possible maximum matching, okay, then we will collect for each of them, we will collect the union of the blue edges. We just make the union of all the edges in all this maximum matching solution. Then the only thing we need to delete is any edge that do not belong to the final collection that would have collected all the edges belonging to at least one maximum matching. The question is it a, do you think that it's a practical approach to do this? Of course it's not, because the number of maximum matching that you could have is possibly exponential. Okay, let's consider n variables. Okay, assume that I have n variables here, x1 to xn, and n values as well. Okay, these are all the values, so 1, 2, until n. Okay, and assume that I have my bipartite variable value graph is complete, is really fully connected. It means that all the variables still have all the values in the domain. How many solutions do you think that this all different constraint have? This all different constraint has. Of course, the number of solutions here is correspond to all the permutations. Okay, so all the permutation, it means n factorial. Okay, and n factorial is obviously exponential. And so it's not a practical approach. You cannot enumerate all the maximum matching. That would be really too time consuming to do this, to just to filter the edges. We don't want to pay. Again, we never want to pay an exponential time to filter the domains of the variables for one specific constraint, because the problem is already most of the time NP complete, so you don't want to use an exponential time algorithm to explore an exponential number of nodes in the search tree. Okay, so we don't want to do that. We need to find something smarter, and the good news is that it's possible, and it's possible we will make use of a very important graph theorem, which comes from a French mathematician, which was Berge. And Claude Berge theorem tells us that an edge belongs to some maximum matching, but not necessarily all of them, okay? Not necessarily all of them, but at least some maximum matching, if and only if, for an arbitrary maximum matching, it belongs to either an even alternating path, which begins at an M3 node, so a node that is not yet taken by the maximum matching that you start with, or an even alternating cycle. So there are two cases here. There are two conditions under which we could state that an edge would belong to at least one maximum matching. And this theorem is stated by using one starting maximum matching. So if you start with one maximum matching, then you have here written the condition to detect all the edges that could belong to some possibly different maximum matching. Okay, so that's a very important theorem, and we will study the two cases independently. Okay, let's start with the first case. Okay, so first, maybe why is this theorem so important? It's simply because the problem of detecting if an edge belongs to some maximum matching is really reduced to the detection of cycles in a directed graph. And detection of cycles in a directed graph is a problem that is well solved. We have algorithms for that, okay? And we will see that we can solve this kind of problem by detecting the strongly connected components in a graph. Okay? So the first case is this one. An edge belongs to some maximum matching if for an arbitrary maximum matching, it belongs to an even alternating path starting at an M3 node. So how many M3 nodes do we have here? We have two, okay? These are the two only edges that do not belong to some maximum matching. And the question is, does this edge, for instance, to some maximum matching? Would it be possible to find a maximum matching in which this edge is in blue? And the theorem tells us that it's possible if we can find an alternating path starting from here. So I will start from here and I will try to discover alternating paths. For instance, this one, then this one. Okay, no, let's take this one, then this one, and then we see that we are stuck. Okay, so this one is already difficult to find. What about this one? We could do this one, and then we go here, and it's difficult as well. Okay, but that's the idea. If we can find an alternating path starting from node, then we found a solution. Okay, so consider this one. We can do this one, and we have found an alternating path, right? Starting at an M3 node. Boom, boom. And as you can see, you could now put this one in blue, but then you need to put this one in white, and you found a new maximum matching. Okay? So the first case is this one, and it works. Okay? So it means that this one can surely be validated and should not be removed by the pruning for the all different constraints, by the filtering for the all different constraints.